Now, ESG and ethical or value-aligned investing has been around for some time now, but the expectations are increasing on what ESG funds should look like. What do you look for when investing?
Yeah, thanks for the question. So ESG or sustainable investing has come a long way and has had a pretty big acceleration over the past 2 years. So you can't really open a newspaper these days without a headline on climate change or modern slavery issues or decarbonizing the economy or cultural concerns within a business. And investors are really starting to take note of what they're invested in. So they're looking at the holdings, they're checking out their superannuation, and it's no longer acceptable to call yourself an ESG or sustainable or SRI fund without having a rigorous process in place or being truly authentic. So I help to manage the Perennial Better Future Trust and also the eInvest Better Future Fund, which is an active ETF quoted on the ASX under the code IMPQ. And these funds go out and actively seek companies that are contributing to a better future. So whether that's improving educational outcomes or employee engagement or providing renewable energy or a company developing low carbon technologies, they might be contributing to a circular economy or improving health outcomes.
And can you explain what greenwashing is? Why is it a risk and what are you doing to avoid it?
Yeah, absolutely. So greenwashing is a concept that has been coined to describe companies or funds that may claim they're green or sustainable, but those claims aren't substantiated and often it's just a marketing ploy. So it is a risk from an investment perspective, because if they aren't actually environmentally friendly or managing their supply chain in an ethical way, that risk of ESG controversy still exists. But additionally, they also expose themselves to reputational damage. And this can have an impact on share prices. And we've seen that happen in the past. I guess what we try to do to look through the claims is focus on company engagement. So as active managers, we have the ability to go in and meet with management teams or board of directors to discuss ESG and sustainability in their business. And this really provides us with an indication of authenticity. So we do a lot of due diligence as well, and that might involve talking to clients or suppliers, verifying claims that they've made, or monitoring external sources for information.
So can you give me some examples of listed companies that you think are doing a great job with ESG, or perhaps ones that you've even invested in?
Yeah, great. So we think companies that perform well in sustainability are just better run businesses. So typically they have management teams that are aware of their ESG risks and opportunities, but also a whole range of other broader risks and opportunities in their business. A really great example of one of these companies is Janison Education, which is listed on the ASX under the code JAN. And Janison creates online assessment and learning platforms for educators or corporations or governments. And we really like Janison because it's a more efficient way of conducting examinations than traditional pen and paper exams. And also it allowed examinations to continue over the COVID period, so to have virtual exams and testing platforms. So also the test can actually be modified to improve outcomes for the student. And it also has significant growth opportunity as a business. So its existing clients include people like the CFA Institute, the OECD, and the British Council. And it is currently profitable and trading at a significant discount to its other SaaS peers. So that's one example of one of our Better Future investments, which is in the education space. Another example is a business called Calix, which trades under the code CXL. And that's an industrial company which provides products and services solving global sustainability challenges. So ESG is really their focus, and it's all through their presentation materials, and management and the board discuss it with investors all the time. And they're, of course, a beneficiary of the increasing focus on ESG and sustainability as more and more flows come into that space. We've had really positive engagement with Calix, and they actually appointed a great, well-qualified, independent female NED to the board. And that was after years of us engaging with them on the benefits of gender diversity. So that was a really positive outcome. But one of their really exciting projects, which gets spoken about a lot, is the CO2 mitigation in the lime and cement industry. So we know that the lime and cement industry contributes to 9% of global greenhouse gas emissions. And so what they're doing is that they've created patented technologies to do carbon capture and storage in the cement process. And they recently announced partnerships with Adbri and also Pilbara Minerals. And the last example I'll talk to today is a company that I'm sure you've probably heard of before, but Kathmandu, which is under the ticker KMD. And Kathmandu is an outdoor apparel and equipment company, and they also acquired Rip Curl a few years ago. And Kathmandu, you know, is in the retail space, so not one that's traditionally thought of as a sustainable industry, but they do have sustainability at the core of what they're doing. So for example, they use 100% sustainable cotton, and they're a certified B Corporation. They also have recycled 20 million plastic bottles into their materials. And they also just recently announced the world's first biodegradable fleece. So I hope that's given you a few examples of some of the really innovative small companies listed on ASX that are really sustainable, both for contributing to better outcomes for the environment and society, but also just really doing good things at their core. And that's how we believe that we've been able to generate really strong performance over time.